Hello students, today I'm back with my next video and I'm going to explain you the second chapter from the book Hornbill, which is a poem. And the name of the poem is A Photograph, written by Shirley Tolson. So before starting with the explanation of the poem, let's begin with a brief introduction about the poet, that is Shirley Tolson. Shirley Tolson, who has died at the age of 94, was a poet, teacher, educational journalist, and editor. And the author of books about walks along the ancient tracks and roads of Britain. She was born Kathleen Shirley Dixon on May 20th in the year 1924. At Henleys-on-Thames. Her father, the author Douglas Dixon, had been a naval commander. Poetry had been a favorite occupation since childhood. Her first exuberant poem was written at the age of 8, and after the children arrived, she decided she wanted to complete her education and write. In Contemporary Poets of the English Language in the year 1970, she declared that she had been received her proper education at a mature age at Birkbeck College, University of London. After that, let's begin with the theme of the poem. A Photograph, written by Shirley Tolson, highlights the memories associated with a photograph. The poetess looks at her mother's photograph when she went for a holiday with the two of her cousins. She remembers how her mother laughed at the way they were dressed for the beach. Now, after so many years of her mother's death, she feels the sea holiday was her mother's past and her mother's smile is her past. She finds the loss and pain inevitable and inexpressible. Hence, the poem is woven around the pain that we feel at the loss of our dear ones. Yet, we have to live with it as a part of life. Now, before starting with the explanation, let's know something about the poetic devices which is used in this poem. The first poetic device which is used in the poem is allusion. An allusion is a reference or an incidental mention of something either directly or by implication. An example of allusion in this poem is cardboard, which actually refers to the photograph. Alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of the initial letter, generally a consonant, of several words, marking the stressed syllable in a line of poem. Examples of alliteration in the poems are stood still to smile, terribly transient, its silence silences, etc. Now student, just have a look. You see that there is a repetition of S consonant, that is stood still to smile. Repetition of T, terribly transient, and repetition of S, its silence silences. Oxymoron. In this literary device, there are two opposite ideas that are joined to create an effect. Labored ease in the poem is an example of an oxymoron. Labor meaning with great difficulty and ease means comfortably. Both words have opposite meanings, but here they are clubbed together. Personification. The example is its silence silences. The situation has been given the human equality of silence. Now here let's begin with the explanation of first stanza. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and she the big girl, some 12 years or so. Now students, first of all, let's know about that what exactly the word paddling means. Paddling here means walking. If you just look at the picture which is shown here in the video, just there are three girls who are walking on the surface of water, which means that they are doing the paddling. Now let's start with the explanation. An old photograph of the poet's mother, which was pasted on cardboard, makes the poet recall the old memories of her mother's childhood. The photograph is a depiction of her mother's enjoyable moments at a sea beach with her two cousins, who were younger to her. They were walking in shallow water with bare feet near the beach. The mother was standing in the middle and holding hands of her two cousins, who were standing on each side. The poet's mother was 12 years old then. It shows that the photograph was very old, but the poet has kept it very carefully as it reminded her of sweet memories of her mother's childhood. The photograph also indicates how enjoyable her mother's childhood was. Second stanza, all three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera, a sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born, and the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Now the word transient means temporary. The photograph shows that all the three girls, that is the poet's mother and her two cousins, Dolly and Betty, stood still and smiled at the camera when their uncle clicked their photograph at the sea beach. As the weather was windy, at that time their hair was flying over their smiling faces. The expression on the faces of the poet's mother and her cousins was that of happiness and enjoyment. The mother was looking very pretty at that time, and the photograph was taken a long time ago. Everything has changed since then. Her mother grew up now. She was dead, and the poet was reviving her memories. The only thing that has remained unchanged is the sea, which was washing the feet of all three girls. The mention of the words transient indicates the ever-changing lives of human being, as well the shortness of their stay in this world. In contrast to the eternality of nature, the girl's life changed drastically during this period, but the sea has not changed. The stanza beautifully explains the transient nature of human being. Third stanza, some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot, see Betty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter. Both rave with the labored ease of loss. Now let's know about the meaning of the words. Ray means mocking, snapshot, photograph, ease, comfort. Now let's begin with the explanation. Even 20-30 years later, the mother would look at the photograph and laugh nostalgically, remembering the happy memories of her past. Mother would look at the photograph and comment on the dresses worn by the cousins, Dolly, Betty, and herself. Sea holiday was her mother's past, and her mother's laughter was become a thing of the past for the poet as her mother was now dead. The poet still remembers how her mother would laugh at the photograph, remembering the sea holiday with a fondness as well as sense of loss, because that time would never come back. In the same way, poet feels nostalgic thinking about her mother and her laughter, which has become a thing of the past. The words labored and ease are opposite to each other, but describe the same entity, loss. Fourth stanza. Now she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived, and the circumstances, there is nothing to say at all, its silence silences. Now, the poet recalls that it is nearly 12 years since the mother died. The poet is consumed with grief, but is left with no words to express her loss and pain. The poet is totally absorbed in memories of her dead mother. The painful silence of this situation leaves the poet speechless. The poet can feel the grief, but is unable to express it through words. The silence caused by death makes the atmosphere gloomy, very sad, where no one is able to utter words. Now students, we finish the explanation, and there are few points to remember so that the poem is going to be crystal clear to all. First point, the poet looks at the cardboard on which there is a childhood photograph of her mother. She had gone for a sea holiday with two of her cousins, Betty and Dolly. While they were paddling, their uncle had a photograph of them. Both the cousins were holding the hands of her mother, who was the eldest among the girls. This was before the poet was born. Time flied past, since all those who are in the photograph underwent changes while the sea remained the same. Her mother would look at the photograph after about 20 to 30 years and laugh nostalgically. Now, for the poet, her mother's laughter and her sea holiday is a thing of the past. Her mother died about 12 years ago. The silence of the photograph silences the past. She experiences great loss. So now students, here are few textbook questions which I want to discuss with you. The first question, what does the word cardboard denote in the poem? Why has this word been used? Now, as you all know, as I've already given you the explanation about the word cardboard, which means a photograph. So the word cardboard denotes the meaning, the word photograph of a mother and two of her cousin. But now this cardboard, rather this photograph, was a faint memory of the mother and two of her cousin when they have gone for the paddling. So now only the frame and the fainted memories of the photograph was there in the poem. Second question. The poet's mother laughed at the snapshot. What did his laugh indicates? So poet's mother laughed at the snapshot because the funniest thing was that about their dressing sense. How the parents of the mother and cousins have dressed up for the beach. So that was the funniest thing which makes mother laugh by looking at the snapshot. What is the meaning of the line, both rave with the labored ease of loss? Both rave with the labored ease of loss here means the incident of a life becoming the things of the past. For instances, a sea holiday is the poet's childhood days was a past for the mother, and with the death of the mother means her laughter is a past for the poet. Everything in life is thus transitory, and gets distorted or fades with the time, and we accept the distortion with ease without being much troubled, because it was a natural phenomena. The one who comes to this world definitely has to leave this world. So for mother, it was the laughter, for the poet, sorry, is the laughter of a mother, which was her past memory, because now the mother was no more, she was dead. The three stanza depicts three different phases. What are they? Yes, three stanza depict three different phases and of life, that is the childhood, the youth and the old age, accompanied with death, which being the final end of life. The childhood days are wrapped with innocence. The youth is marked with gaiety and laughter, which is the essence of youthful energy. And then becomes the loneliness created by death. So death is the final journey of our life. So these are the three phases, that is the childhood, the youth and the old age, which has been depicted as the three different phases in the poem. So students, we finish with the poem. Hope you like the video. Thank you.